Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the playthrough of Gran Turismo 7. We are doing the Willow Spring Circuit experience, starting with it, and we will be doing Big Willow, Variation 1, Streets of Willow Springs, and then we will be doing Horse Thief Mile. They all look quite complex, a lot of corners. Especially the streets of Willow Springs, but yeah, let's see how it goes. And also, maybe I will do the full lap attack menu. Wait a bit, then the interface should disappear, and then we can have a nice view of some of the corners. Usually takes a couple of seconds. Here we go. All right, this provides a nice overview of how the corners interconnect, how sharp they are compared to each other. All right, so there's quite an incline over here, you see. It's a little bit of a height difference. Start, finish. No idea which direction we will be going, from left to right or right to left. The fastest road in the west. I do like the car that we will be driving here. I hope it also has good characteristics. Alright, this looks all quite, it looked on paper quite technical, but it also looks quite fast, that section. But anyways, the Corvette, it's really, of course, a purebred American car in the yellow Le Mans colors, or at least what I associate with Le Mans, those yellow Corvettes. I hope that it handles better than the Dodge Viper did. Also a very cool car, but it handled like crap on Laguna Seca. In my view, it really didn't want to steer in. Hopefully this car is better. Right, this Willow Springs is sponsored by Toyota, apparently. I do like really the little building over there, like a wooden shack. It really has like a 60s feel to it, this track, somehow, I find. Alright, so this is the opposite part of the straight. Does look, here's the straight to the left, then. Alright, this gives a really nice overview of this little track variation. Here, check it out. This is like a pretty damn cool track building. Alright, so there really is some banking and height differences. Right, to the left, to the right, right, flowing, and then a big right-hander. Sorry, I'm taking my time a bit with this. I'd also like just to watch the graphics, etc. But also, in the end, I think it does help me. Here, for instance, this one. This really helps with getting a feel track. Very nice picture shots. So that's the slow corner where the car is now, and then it looks to be all quite quick corners. Right, hopefully the car will no, unfortunately not. I was wondering, hoping that it would speed by still in the camera shot. There it goes. Right. Let's try and tackle this. Let's start with the sectors. Oh, wrong button. Alright, left-hander and then a pretty wide right-hander. Left hand 90 degrees and then I don't know what that is, 190 degrees or something. There we go. Too fast. Nope, I need to brake earlier. I was still braking at the 50 meter marker. Let's do 75. It's an amazing sight. Alright, nice. Almost went off track. Sector 2. Left-hander, then yeah, some weird right-hander and then a flowing right, left, right. Ah, I remember this corner. I really have fun. I remember this one from here. This is a very tricky corner from Gran Turismo Sports. Very tricky corner. Because of the camber as well. Very hard to that corner on top of this little hill. It sharpens up, it seems, at the end, and then there's also a little bit of the outside of the corner is lower than the inside, so it's like a negative banking, so to say, and then you really easy spin out. That negative banking, I'm not sure, let's test it out. But way longer. Gave up more speeds. Maybe good to keep it in third, less risk of spinning out. Corner. this car even spins out in thirds if you apply too much steering input and throttle. Better time, and it felt way worse. Alright, I don't really dislike this car, it's a pretty okay car. It's just this corner which is really so tricky. You really have to brake before you see the end of the corner. Second corner, you have to brake before you see where you're going. A little bit. Here you have to apply a bit, you have to brake over here because here it starts tightening down. Somehow that was gold. Felt really messy, but gold is gold. I'm happy with it. And now for the final one, which is just straight on, and then a faint right-hander that narrows onto the start-finish straights, or that sharpens up with another right-hander up onto the start-finish. Amazing brakes, crazy. I applied too much braking. Let's do that again. With less braking. Barely gold, but gold is gold, good enough for me. And now we are going for the full lap time. Hopefully the time is not too sharp, because I don't really like this track. It was a very lenient time, because it really was not that good of a track or a lap. But nice that I'm finally making some progress without spending hours and hours of failed attempts. I will quickly guide you through what I found as the breaking points. This is just full speed and over here. Just before the 50 meter marker, shave off some speed, get back to fifth. There's quite a lot of grip. The corner looks quite sharp, but it's also a little bit banked. So yeah, you can take it quite quickly. I kept it in fifth. Maybe you could also go back to fourth, I don't know. Well, I don't think you even need to brake here. This is just a matter of coasting, keeping the speed as high as possible without going wide. And then this is all quite faint. And then over here it sharpens up a bit, but you can already here apply more throttle. I think I may even be already at full acceleration over here. Here, just before the 50 meter marker, get back to third gear, speed out, keep the car rolling through this corner, coasting through it. Here you can apply a bit of throttle, but over here, while you don't really see the exit of the corner, already start braking a bit, because the corner opens up, it tightens down here, so you want to hug the inside and then be able to exit as soon as possible. Full throttle, and then over here get back to third and coast through the corner. And over here open it up, and this corner is quite faint, so you can just take it full throttle. Shine to the left, just brake a little bit, get back to fifth and coast through it. The corner sharpens up, but again somehow there's a lot of grip here, so even if you're going almost 200 kilometers an hour, you can just make this corner even while applying throttle from this point onwards. Then it's just a matter of pedal to the metal towards the finish line. So let's get one time, or without commentary. Thank you. outside to replace the Gran Turismo. Pretty cool replay, I must say. This car in the Wild West of the United States of America. Anywho, I think that about wraps up this episode. Again, cannot make them too long because YouTube has a hard time processing big HDR files. We will be driving a Mustang on the streets of Willow Springs. So the start finish seems to be the same, but for the rest I think it's totally different. There are not a lot of shared sections here, at least not that I can make out. But that will be in the next episode. Guys, hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you there. And for the meantime, do not forget to always keep on gaming, selector.